कलये सुन्दराकारं सदैक प्रियदर्शनं अज्ञाननाशकं
Baranda,
देवं सद्गुरुं मुरलीधरं. With immense blessings of our beloved Guru Maharaj, we are relishing the verse-by-verse meaning of the Mahamantra Kirtan. And it is said in Bhagavata Dharma, whether we follow it or whether we hear about it or even Anumodito, even if you say that's a great dharma, it gives the same fruit. So when we think about Mahamantra Kirtan and enjoy its greatness, it is as effective as chanting the divine name also. So singing Mahamantra Kirtan itself is singing Mahamantra. It is said by Kabir Das Ji, Ek Shabd Guru Dev Ka Taka Anant Vichar तके मुनि जन पंडिता वेद न पावे पार. He said that one word of a Sadguru gives ananta vichar. It gives limitless meanings. And even great muni, great pandits cannot find its boundary, limit. And why talk about pandits and munis? Even Veda Mata can't find the limit of such profound words of a Mahatma. When such is the greatness of every word of our beloved Guru Maharaj, what we are trying to do as we keep reminding ourselves is, we are trying to merely scratch the surface, take a little uttarini, uttarina, one spoon of water from the ocean of nectar. And that itself is enough for us, gives us tremendous joy. So we saw Kaliyayum Balikollum. Kaliyayum has two meanings in Tamil. Kaliyaye Balikollum. Even Kali can be destroyed. Remember the sonnet which we all learnt in our school, one of the Shakespeare's sonnet, I think. Thou shall feed on death that feeds on men. Death once dead, there is no more dying then. Do you know the sonnet? So Kali spells death to the soul of all the people living in that age. Because dharma is dharmena hina pashubhish shamana, it is said. In Ramayanam it is said. Mahabharatam also says that if we don't have any dharma, we are no longer humans. So Kali is attacking dharma, which is the very root of humanity, which is totally what humans are all about, is dharma. And when Kali attacks dharma, it is destroying humanity. No? But there is something which destroys Kali, and that is Mahamantra Kirtan. So the word Kaliyayum means Kaliyaye in one way. Kaliyayum also has another meaning. Kali means kalo kalmasha chittanam papadravyopa jivinam vidikriya vihinanam gatir govinda kirtanam. One of the smriti, one of our shastras sloka says that Kali means kalmasha chittam. That kalmasha chittam means a conflicted mind. Kali means conflicted mind. The reason why we know dharma yet not follow it is because of a conflicted mind. You see? So Kali ayum balikollu means, not only does Mahamantra Kirtan set right our mind so that it becomes dharmic, it also leads to even the complete annihilation of the mind. Moksha varaikum it will take. So when he says Kaliyayum, he has to answer now what else. If somebody, a mother says, I want something to eat. Suppose a child tells the mother, I want something to eat. The mother says, Unakund. The mother says, you will also get it. It means somebody else is also going to get it. Na? So when our Swamiji says Kaliyayum Balikullum, that it completely annuls the ill effects of Kali. What else does it do? He explains that in the next stanza, Mukti Nalgidum Kirtanam Padire. It not only sets your mind in order, it not only clears the cobwebs of our chitta, it actually leads to something which is far more greater, which is moksha itself, which means complete freedom from the clutches of samsara. So here Kaliyayum Bali means not only does it completely destroy the ill effects of Kali, which is confused, conflicted mind, it also destroys the cause of the conflicted mind, which is Ajnana. So even the Ajnana, the lack of wisdom or ignorance we all have, the spiritual ignorance, is dispelled by the light of Bhagavan Nama Kirtanam. So Kaliyayum Bali means it not only destroys the ill effects of a confused mind, it destroys something far more fundamental, which is the cause of a confused mind is ignorance. If we know that we are Atma Swarupa, there is no place for mind to play tricks, isn't it? So Kaliya Yum means not only does it put our mind in order, Mukti Nalgidum, it completely removes the cause of the mind vacillating like this, which is Ajnana itself. And that Ajnana is in form of the 16 Avaranas. It will remove all the 16 Avaranas and give you Moksha. Now between clarifying and giving shanti to the mind and moksham, everything else comes inside. You see, you said, what do we all seek finally? We all seek only peace. Many people say, Sal, all I want is only happiness, Sar, is what they say in India. Are, that's what everybody wants. What do you think? Happiness is so trivial or what? You think money is greater than happiness? So here people think, they downplay the importance of happiness. They say, all I want is to be happy, sir. That's what everything from blade of grass to Brahma wants, happiness. And that is the goal of life. Until we attain that Anandam, which is Anantam, which is Bhagavan Sri Krishna, Sachidananda Rupaya. Without attaining Krishna, who is Sachidananda Rupam, no Ananda is possible. Everybody is running towards that only. So Kaliya Yum, means and. Also, this here is also. So here what it means is Kaliya Yum Balikollum. Tuli niyamamum illada. And if you want to get a little more of the depth of this verse, it's not only the dharma for Kali Yuga, it is dharma for all the four yugas. So it is not only Kaliyayum Balikollum, the ill effects of Treta Yuga, ill effects of Dwapara Yuga, if at all there is any ill effects in Krita Yuga, even that only Nama Sankirtana can actually completely destroy. So Kaliyayum means not only for the fourth yuga, is for all the four yugas, especially for Kali Yuga. So Kaliya Yum Balikollum. So whatever is Adharma in Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, etc., Adhum Balikollum. So the beauty with the first verse is Kaliya Yum Balikollum, Tuli Niyamamum Illada, without any rules or restrictions or regulations, Niyama Samanya Anapekshitvam Adikye Karanam, says Sahasranama Bhashya. Bhashyakara says that. So that is the beauty of Kaliyayum Balikollum. There was once, this happened a few years back, a Mahatma was explaining Ajamila Charitra, Bhagavata Pravachana. And not many were there, all were all intimate devotees. So when there are intimate disciples, the Pravachan has a very different depth. And when it is done publicly, it has a different depth. Bruyuhu, Snigdhasya Sishyasya, Guruvo, Gukhyam Apyuta. Generally, when a guru is very happy, and there is a close set of people sitting with the guru, the way in which a guru explains Bhagavatam, the depth of it will be very different. We all know that. Such was a Mahatma, he was explaining Ajamila Charitra. And because they were only intimate set of people, he went into this tremendous relish, into tremendous mood of Nama Siddhantam. And he said, Satyatra Satyam, I tell you truly, in Kali, without Nama Sankirtana, there is no other way. No other way can reach us God. And then one person, a sannyasi, took his hand up. And he said, that Mahatma is in that bhavana. He says, what? He said, I object. Imagine when a Mahatma is explaining Nama Mahatmyam and somebody raises the hand and says, I object. Mahatma got a little surprised. He said, what do you object? I object to the fact that you are telling Nama Sankirtana will work only in Kali. You should say in all the four yugas, Nama Sankirtana is the way. Immediately, tears of joy flew from the Mahatma. He ran towards the person asking the question, embraced him tight and said, this is what I also am trying to tell you and I fully agree with you. So Kaliya Yumna, not only the last yuga, all the four yugas, anywhere, anytime, our Bhagavan Nama Kirtanandam Gati. That's the only Gati for us. So Kaliya Yumbali Kullum Tulli Niyamamum Illada Kirtanam paadire, Kirtanam paadire. Generally, twice he has said Kirtanam paadire, paadire. When you say paadire, it also means, as I said in the first day, respect. Paadire also means plural. So he is not telling one set of people, other set of people. He is telling Vayyarthu Vaalvir, God. Anybody who is living, that's why in Sahasranama introduction, we all heard it today. Now, every day we are listening and chanting Sahasranama. Kim Jantuhu. Sahasranama, the question asked by our Yudhishthira is, anything which is living, what is the way out for it?
So what is for a jantu? Jantuna, that which is living. So for a jantu, what is the way out? What is the highest dharma for a jantu? And the answer is this. So that is the reason why it is addressing the entire universe. Let us all together chant the divine name. If you can't chant, at least listen to the divine name. And that's why kirtanam padire, kirtanam padire. And here, kirtanam means just kirtanam nale patidane. So kirtanam padire means, kirtanam means just uttering the divine name. And since it's a mahamantra kirtanam, here he is saying, why don't you add a little raga to it and sing that also? And that gives us a greater relish. If you can't sing, no problem. You can just chant. So we can either do Mahamantram as a japam. We have, Swamiji has also, out of his tremendous grace, recorded and given. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Kaliyayum balikullum dhulini. Here he is saying, this is one way to chant. Another way is to sing. I'm telling you a kirtan about Mahamantra. So let us all sing along with it. And that is why he says, kirtanam padire, kirtanam padire. Or maybe he said, like our Andal said, it all starts with only our tongue chanting it. The mind may not be interested or may not be involved. As we keep chanting slowly, the mind also gets involved. And Adi Shankara Bhagavatpada's philosophy is, without the mind getting involved at least a wee bit, our tongue will not chant the divine name. So vayinal vadi, manadinal sindhika. Both are called bhajan. So here kirtanam padire is vayinal padi, and that portion of the mind which is involved in the mouth singing that kirtan is another kirtanam padire with the mind getting involved. So in what? Kirtanam padire. The second stanza, we saw the philosophy behind it. The basic problem with all of us is very simple, ajnanam. We don't know who we are. We don't know who Krishna is. We don't know our connection. What is the problem? Kamam, krodham, madam, lobham and all are all small manifestation of the fundamental problem. And so Mahamantra addresses the problem. It hits the root of ajnana by making us chant the divine name. How does it actually remove the 16 avarnas? How does it remove the, dispel the darkness of ajnana and then give us jnana is what he's going to explain in the ninth stanza. So here the first stanza talks about the general scheme of what is going to be sung. The second stanza goes deeper into detail. As we go down, it says how it gives moksha, you see. And that philosophy is also explained in that song. And that is the beauty of the second stanza. Mukti nalgedam, finish. Now, what else do we want? And we will be completely relieved of our ajnanam. And the third stanza talks about not only moksha, it also takes care of our present, clear and present problems we have now. And worldly problems. It also helps us to progress spiritually. You need not look at anything else, because three types of people chant the divine name. Etan nirvidhyamananam icchatam kutobayam yoginam nirnitam harer namana kirtanam. People who want mandulaga asai. People who want worldly desires. Icchatam. Icchatam na, you have some desires, I have some desires. And people who have desires also chant the name. And icchatam akutobayam yoginam rupanirnitam. And the people who also wants freedom, who wants vinulagase, who wants jnana, bhakti, vairagya, they also chant the divine name. It doesn't stop there. People who are yogis, people who have had a sakshatkara, people who are already jivan muktas, they also chant the divine name. So three types of people. People who have mannulagase, is jagaki ichchaye, ichchatam. And then the people who are actually seeking freedom from desires, mumukshus. And people who are siddhas, people who are already attained, jivan muktas, acharya purushas, they also chant the divine name. So the Mahamantra starts catering to our worldly desires and enhances our faith in the Mahamantra. And then it inspires us to ask for something better, because it purifies us. Na? And when it purifies, our desires, our outlook, what we are inspired with also changes, you see. So more as we already discussed in the ladder, bhakti ladder stuff, instead of getting inspired by somebody became a millionaire overnight, somebody has achieved a world record for something, all that inspiration is only for Rajasa Adhikari. as we progress, we feel very happy. We applaud them. We feel very happy for other success. But for me, my definition of success becomes more inward. Na, I start thinking, how do I make my thoughts come less? How do I develop more love in my heart? How do I start seeing things as they are? How do I make sure that I don't react to stuff which are very trivial? And this is how you start measuring your success. So then you start looking at Prahlada, Dhruva, and then more recently, the great Mahatmas, they would inspire us more than all this millionaire, billionaire, etc., who write stories, most of which I seriously doubt its truth. We tend to believe that and not believe our Shastras. You see, we should not, not us. I'm just telling people outside of this group. So they generally believe more in all these stories which are coming out, written by all these famous personalities, which is all made up, I'm sure, a little bit at least. Shastras, nothing is made up. Everything is 100% truth, isn't it? We all realize it. I'm talking more about people outside. So here, slowly we aspire for something greater. Nama Sankirtana will take us there. Finally, when we realize, then we chant the Maha Mantra not for any other purpose. We don't get anything out of it. We get everything in it, which is sweetness, which is the joy, which is gratitude. And I don't know, we need to go there to understand how we chant Maha Mantra after realizing, O Nama Ni Namam, O Rama Ni Namam, E Me Ruchira, he says. So that is the state. So the general example is, sometime back we have been to airports, where there is this walkulator or something where you just stand and the walkulator takes you to one end to the other. All you need to do is not walk the opposite direction. If you just stand, that which it's like a conveyor belt, what do you call it, walkulator or whatever, a walkway, automatic walkway takes you from one end to another. And you have to do nothing. You just have to stand in the walkway. If you start walking the opposite direction, so if you just hold on to the divine name, it takes care of our progress. So here in Hindi, we could not bring evam, we could not bring and, or. In Tamil, just is enough. Yeah. So can I come? You can also come, already big people are there. So here is jag ki ichaye paralok ki kamnaye kshan mein kare pradan. So it gives us manulaga asai, vinulaga asai, and then no asai at all, and anbu, and that state nama comes automatically. You see, that is the beauty of that verse. All whatever desires your kshaname, in one kshanam, it actually grants it. And today we understood what it was in the Ramayana Parayana. Here, Vibhishana Alvar crosses the ocean and falls at the feet of Ramachandra Prabhu. He says, Sarvaloka Sharanyaya Raghavaya Mahatmane. He comes and surrenders. We should see Vibhishana Sharanagati separately. We'll do one session just for Vibhishana Sharanagati. Mahatmas have poured about the greatness of Sharanyan, of the greatness of Sharanagatan, and the greatness of Sharanagati, Piriyavachan Pillayanna, Swami Desikananna, all these great Mahatmas have poured. We will see just Vibhishana Sharanagati one day. And here Vibhishana Alvar comes and falls at the feet of Ramachandra Prabhu. Now Vibhishana Alvar technically is not aspiring for any Rajyam, etc. But then Ramachandra Prabhu thought, I have to give you something. And the moment he surrendered, even though Ramachandra Prabhu did not even step into Lanka yet, he took a little water from the nearby water body, which is generally you don't use seawater for Abhishekam. But out of his, he wanted to immediately give. He made Vibhishana sit in the banks, in the shore of Rameshwaram, took that water, coronated him then and there. Kana Poludin Lalgidam. Which means it's a done deal. Afterwards, this 18 days war or 30 days war or whatever war we fought is all formality. I told you, I put me 1 month time off between the check and realizing. America, if you send a check to all our Veda Padas, it takes 1 month. Granted, no. The moment you wrote that check and posted, now you have done your job. Adhikapur in this bank, that bank, a lot of procedure is there. You can't escape. Likewise, there are a lot of procedures. Bhagavan has to take care of the cosmos also, no? So he has to do a little procedure, ing adjustment, the ledger, அதுக்கெல்லாம் யூ ஷுட் கிவ் ஹிம் டைம் பட் இட் இஸ் கிராண்டட் இமீடியட்லி see kana poludu nil nalgidum here our swamiji says he was discussing about a great mahatma from Shringeri matham and he has written a book called guru krupa vilasam in that Piriva says that there are three types of anugraha possible by divinity whether guru or nama or bhagavan all the three one he says some of the problems we have can be immediately solved without a trace மொத்தமா அடியோட இட் கேன் பி டேக்கன் அண்ட் அப்ரூட்டட் ஃப்ரம் த ரூட் சோ தட் வீல் நெவர் வி டோன்ட் ஈவன் நோ இட் வாஸ் டு கம் டு அஸ் தட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ பாசிபிள் சம் ஆஃப் த ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் த சிவியாரிட்டி கேன் பி ரெடியூஸ்ட் பட் தேர் ஆர் சம் கர்மா விச் பகவான் திங்ஸ் இஸ் குட் ஃபார் அஸ் டு ஆக்சுவலி சீ த்ரூ சோ தட் வி கம் அவுட் ஆஃப் இட் மேபி வைஸ் ஐ டோன்ட் நோ ஆர் வி கம் அவுட் ஆஃப் இட் ஸ்ட்ராங்கர் ஆர் he doesn't want to stop it he is independent he is swatantra he can stop it but he chooses not to and the reason for that is only divine we don't know so he says when we have a problem and we pray by chanting the divine name etc or when we have a desire and in the desire we pray both are it's both ways na anvayam vidirek so here if we pray and chant the divine name some of our desires are fully met more than what we want also is given by the prayer by naam Some prayers, we want something, we get something out of it, but not the whole thing what we desired. And finally, some things we pray for, yet we don't get it, you see. And Swamiji says, all the three are anugraham because you have chanted and prayed for it. If we prayed for something and didn't get it, I think the way we should actually take it is good for that we didn't get it. For example, a child goes and prays for a lot of things from mother. It can even strike, okay. Hartal Mari. It can say that I won't do this, I won't do that and all that stuff. And the mother will smilingly look at the child and say, I won't give you. Then when the child is mature, it realizes it's good that my mother didn't give me because the mother wants to give me. But if she gives me this, maybe it is not good for me. Now, a mature child will understand. Likewise, this kana poludinil nalgidum, goodness or blessings and grace is granted. And nalgidum actually means grace also. So it is granted. And when it comes to our hand, etc., is up to divinity to decide. It is always done for the best of our long-term spiritual journey. You see? So remember one thing when we pray, all sudden, and yes, we have day-to-day problems. It's all important. This wonderful quote is from a European spiritual person. I think he's a priest in France. And that what he says is what our Gita says. But since you are talking English, I'm using the English quote from him. He didn't say anything which is not in our Shastras. But our Rigveda says, get the best from all places na, and then denounce. He says that we are not human beings undergoing a spiritual journey. We are spiritual beings undertaking a human journey. The moment we understand the difference, it's not a play of words. It is a complete different paradigm of looking at our life. If we think I am a human being undertaking a spiritual journey, na adu or tick anga. You know, like another comment saying, I am so and so, I love sports, I love cinema, I also am very spiritual, na andha mari aidum. But if you are clear, I am a spiritual person and I am undergoing a human journey for a purpose, and that human journey is there for my spiritual fulfillment, it is true for everybody, whether it's our children, parents, spouse, or our own peers. Everybody is undergoing a journey. And the journey is milestone right now, from this station to that station. That travel is in form of a human clothing. And the journey is fundamentally spiritual. And the milestones are basically human, you see. And so instead of thinking I'm a human being undertaking a spiritual journey, our Shastras have always insisted that we are a spiritual person, a spiritual being undertaking a human journey. Then we understand. When we pray, when we chant, etc., Bhagavan does not look at the human journey part of it. He is actually looking at how do I take this little spiritual being who is my child, my amsam, mamaivamso jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana, how do I take him to the place which he needs rather than what he desires right now? So at times, fulfillment of desires is needed for somebody to be pushed forward. At times, denial is needed for that person to go forward. Only Bhagavan knows. Na. So that is the reason kana poludin nalgidum. It has got the attention, the grace is already there. And how we get the grace can be in various packages, complete package, partial package, or a package where package is not the point. You become stronger when you come out of this ordeal or a prayer. And then comes, when we hear all that, that manulaga say, vinulaga, I say two in one, you see. Then we are concerned, any spiritual thing, if you say, let us do Radha Kalyanam, Sita Kalyanam, the first thought you all get is, how much will it cost? What is the budget and all that? Na? Good news, zero budget. That's how Naam Sankirtan should be. Not even prasadam. Now you understand the importance of one banana now. Na? Now one apple, we know how much precious it is now. Na? So that's why we always insisted when we come for Nama Bhiksha, Porulo selavillai enino arulo kuvindidum karuvil varar kaakum keertanam paadire. Porulo selavillai dhana karchana ho jisuse. This is taken right from Sahasranama Bhashyam. The kodharma sarva dharmanam bhavatah paramo matah. Kinjapan muchyate jantuhu janma samsara bandhanat. Yudhishthira is asking na, in Sahasranama. So here, kodharma sarva dharmanam bhavatah paramo matah. And shrutva dharman aseshena pavananicha parantapa pavananichaha. And Yudhishthira is asking punareva bhashya. What is he asking? Ko dharma sarva dharma. After listening to all dharmas, Yudhishthira is asking which dharma is supreme. So aseshena pavananicha sarvashaha Yudhishthira shantanamam. Yudhishthira is asking the son of Shantanu, which is our Bhishmacharya, this question. So obviously aseshena means without anything baki, without any residue, has told the complete dharma shastram. And generally, when you ask a question, punareva bhashata, when you ask a question again, it means only two things. One, you didn't tell me completely, or I missed something. Only either of these two, na? But here clearly said, aseshena shrutva. So in one word, he has told everything. Not only was everything given, he was also received. Shrutva, na? He listened to everything. Not heard, listened. Yet, punareva bhashata. Yet he asked again. So generally, why do people ask again? Possibly because you told me some dharma, I want to listen to it once more. You can say that now. When somebody says, can you please sing that song once more? Na? You like it. But dharma shastra, it is not a rasa shastram. Na. How do you wash your feet? How do you wash your mouth? It is instruction. Once you understand, you don't have to keep repeating. In fact, if you listen to dharma shastra and not do it now, double papam. Teriyama pandlena, small papam. If we know and not do it, Mahapapam. And you ask again and again, repeat this again and not. It's not for that reason. Yudhishthira is asking, you told me all this dharma, but none of this is going to be practical for people in future. You know, there is dharma is so much in our shastras that it tells us how to even brush our teeth. Which stick to use on which day, which stick not to use on which day. Number, we are using some stick which you are not supposed to. Well, I'm practical possible in Kali. But Shastras are there. Our Mahatmas say when they read the Shastras, they get tears. You know, so much of detail. They have adjusted the ninth decimal of an equation, you see, so that it can be even better, even better. Number, base decimal is a problem. Let's not go to decimal places. The base state itself is a problem. So here, the reason why he asked is, you told me all this dharma. Tell me a simple dharma which all can follow. See, tell one dharma which all can follow, which gives the same or even better benefits. Because in spite of bahu prayasa, we get alpalabham. Palam is alpa. After doing all this dharma, what do I get? You get swargam, parat. But here, if you say devachi ye dwari ubakshanavari tene mukti chari hari mukhe mana, you just say hari na, moksha dwara is open for you. So Yudhishthira is asking very beautifully, show me a simple way which gives the highest fruit. Analpa prayasa alpa prayasai analpa palam. This is what I want, and that is the reason why he's saying the greatest dharma is kirtana dharma And instead of one nama, he gave 1,000 namas here. And in that, our Adishankara Bhagavatvada says, Asya Stuti Lakshanasya Kirtanasya Atikye Kim Karanam Uchyate. Why is Nama Sankirtana Dharma the supreme dharma? He says 5 reasons. Some say 6. Himsadi, there is no himsa at all. For Nama Sankirtana, you don't even have to break a coconut. No himsa. Himsadi, Kalantara, Deshantara, Dravyantara. There is absolutely no expense at all. Dravyantara anapekshitvam solrar liya. The greatness of Nama Sankirtanam is it does not demand an expenditure of even a paisa. And that's why our Swamiji says, taking that from the Bhashyakara of our Vishnu Sahasranama, Dana Karchana Ho Jisuse, Porulo Selavillai. And see, Yeninum. Generally, we think more we spend on dharma, greater is the fruit, na? Not required. If you want a very alpa example, just because I put $1 million on a sinking company, it does not give you dividends at all. Yeah, I invested $1 million. But what did I get out? Na? Zero. Crash at the bimbal. Yeah. Likewise, just because we invest something big doesn't mean returns need to be big. Even if I invest a small amount somewhere, I can get a big return. Like that, our Bodhendra Swamigal says, this is alpa prayasa, but analpa palan, ananta palan. And the example given by our Swamiji, which is more contemporary, is atom is very small. But if you split the atom, the energy is immense. It can solve the energy crisis of the world, you see. And that is the greatness of Dhana Karchana Ho Jisuse, Bharumar Krupa Jisuse, Lautayena Kokumejo, Esa Kirtana Gavore, Purulo Selavillai, no expense at all. Just sit down and chant Mahamantra. Eninim Arulo Kuvindidum. The amount of grace is heaped. Kuvindidum na heaped. Kuvindidum means generally when you go and say, sir, just please give me one chocolate. And then he gives you a handful of chocolate which you can't even carry back home. So much he has given. That is called Kuvindidum. So we get more than what we even bargained for. And that's the reason why many people cry saying, I don't deserve it. I don't deserve it. Nobody deserves grace. You see. There is nobody who says, I deserve Krishna Kripa or Guru Kripa. And it is always heaped on us. And why? Because we don't even pray for, I don't want to be born again. Whenever we say no rebirth, na, we feel very sad. If we say no re-death, na, we say very happy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's a very good thing. When we say birthlessness, na, we feel as if we are losing something. When we say deathlessness, we feel very happy about it. Both are same only. Jata sehi dhruva mrityu na. So karuvil varamal kakum. We will never have to sit in the womb of a mother again if we chant the Mahamantra. And we will see more of it tomorrow. We started off with 10 minutes. So we will do it aramse. But the meaning is very simple. The grace is heaped on us. Because even if we don't pray, Bhagavan understand what we need. We need not be born again. We will be in the state of Anandam. We will be close to the feet of Krishna once we finish this life stretch. You see, that's what it says here.